Hi! In this tutorial, we'll show you how to make a zoom speed ramp effect. It's a pretty handy technique that helps you make a video look more dynamic, and it's great if you're editing a news report, for example. Okay, let's get started and switch to the Prime workspace. Then add your footage. In the template window, type zoom and drag the zoom effect to the scene. Set the effect duration at about 2 seconds. Then find levels and open the additional settings for this parameter. It's that little three-dot icon. Switch to parameter change along a Bezier curve. Great! Now create a control point on the graph. It should have a value of 175%. Carefully drag the vector to create a smooth curve. Shift the control point to the left a bit. And leave it around the first quarter of the graph. Then drag the vector of the first point. Create the same control point around the third quarter of the graph. Perfect! Half a second of zooming in, then holding, then zooming out for another half a second. Duplicate these control points using markers right on the effect, and use the option visible in self-scope and in child objects. If you want to zoom in on a specific part of the scene, you'll need to repeat these steps for the center XY parameters. To do that, switch to linear parameter change along a trajectory. Then place a cursor on the marker and drag the crosshair cursor to the desired spot on the scene. Then copy the parameters of the control point for the second marker. Go back to the template window and find the motion blur effect. Drag it to the scene and make sure it's placed above the zoom effect. The duration of motion blur should be around 2 seconds as well. Once you set that up, find levels and open the additional settings for this parameter. Switch to parameter change along a Bezier curve. Duplicate the markers on the effect, just like we did before. Then duplicate the control points for the first and third quarters of the graph. Both should have a zero value. Finally, in the middle between the quarters, create additional points and set their values at 20. Drag the vector And voila, we have a beautiful smooth curve. Now to the fun part. For each effect, find object drawing duration and the parameter named lock to parent duration. Switch to no. Select both effects on the timeline, hit the cross sign in the template window, and save this combination to your library as a new effect. And if you want to save the effect duration as well, right mouse click on it and check this box. Now you can add another video to the scene and apply your new effect within one click. And that's how you create new effect templates for future projects. If you guys liked this tutorial, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Your support really means the world to us. Until next time.